Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm going to talk about using SQL Server Management Studio, or SSMS, and Azure Data Studio to query and manage instances of SQL Server and Synapse. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. So I did a video on writing your first query, and I got a few comments. Well, Patrick, how do I connect to SQL Server on my Synapse server more specifically? And what tools are you using? So I decided, hey, maybe I should step back before I continue those querying videos and show you the tools of the trade. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing you want to do is you need to download both of the tools. If you download SQL Server Management Studio, you'll notice there's an important note here that says, as of the 18.7 version of Management Studio, Azure Data Studio is automatically installed alongside of it. If you don't want Management Studio and you want to go directly with Azure Data Studio, you can go and download it directly from its own download page, depending on what you're trying to do. So I've been using SQL Server for a long time, and my default was SSMS. And I used to use SQL Server Management Studio because it was like this all-encompassing tool when it came to SQL Server. I could manage my SSIS packages. I could set up security. I could manage an entire group of servers with this single tool. And then they introduced Azure Data Studio. When Azure Data Studio first came out, it didn't have all these capabilities, but now there's some extensions that you can install that's bringing it up to par. But the big difference for me, at least, is with SSMS, you can manage not just SQL Server, but you can also connect to SSAS, or you can connect to your XML endpoint if that's something you're interested in. You can connect to SQL Server reporting services, a Power BI report server. You can connect to SSIS instances, both on-premises in the cloud. With Azure Data Studio, it's kind of limited. Anyway, I'm going to focus on just connecting to these and querying them, all right? And so let me show you how you would find the endpoint so you can connect to your SQL or your Synapse. That's where you start to do your query. So you would open up Management Studio and you get connected. And like I said, if you click this little drop down, once it opens up, it'll actually open with this dialog window. I'm going to close it and we'll come back to this. And I want you to take a look at this connect option. You see, you can connect to just about anything: the database engine, analysis services, integration services, reporting services, so many things. We're going to focus on the database engine today. So if I click on database engine, I need to get my server name. If you're connecting to Synapse, you go out to your Synapse server and you can choose dedicated SQL endpoint or serverless endpoint. It doesn't matter. So you just go ahead and copy it to your clipboard, head over to Management Studio, paste it in there, and then you have some options on how you want to authenticate. Depending on how you configured your Synapse server, you may be able to use SQL Server authentication and Azure Active Directory authentications, completely depending on how you set it up. I'm going to go ahead and choose Azure Active Directory, put in your username, click connect. If this is your first time authenticating, it's going to prompt you for some authentication. You can expand this out and then you can see the databases, you can right click, start querying, and things like that. With Azure Data Studio, it's just a little different. Once you get it installed, you have some options at the top, and you would click on this new connection option. You can see it's only SQL Server right now. Put in your endpoint for your server, and then choose your authentication type. If you had never connected before, you need to add an account, choose a tenant, specify the database, and get connected. And now you can see I have different groupings and things like that. I could expand this out, right click, and start querying it, editing the data, doing some design work. But there's a really interesting thing that's happening over here with Azure Data Studio. There's this ability to add extensions, and it's been there for the longest, but what I'm really excited about is this SQL admin pack, and I'll probably come do a video just on this admin pack a little later. But just like that, you've connected to your SQL server using Azure Data Studio, you've connected to it using SSMS, but you can connect to either and use either to query. Why I'm leaning to Azure Data Studio is because I can create these notebooks and I can have a series of queries that I can run them all. I can run them individually, possibly do some like ETL using this notebook. Maybe I'll do a video on that. All right, what do you guys think? Are you in the SSMS camp or are you in the Azure Data Studio camp? Doesn't matter. Either will allow you to connect to SQL or Synapse, all right? So if you have any questions, comments, I'd love to know. You know what to do. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If you're first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.